We recently introduced in the FNC component collection the FNC Filter Dialogue, and today in this video I want to show you how you can take advantage of this Filter Dialogue in connection with our FNC Data Grid. So I'm going to cover how you can perform the dataset filtering with the Filter Dialogue and visualize the data in the FNC Data Grid. But I'm also going to show you how you can take advantage of the filtering in connection with a data grid that is not connected to a dataset, a data grid that is filled with custom data. So follow me in the Delphi IDE and let's explore these options for you. And here we have it, Delphi 12.2 with the FNC data grid showing data from a client data set. And of course, we Delphi developers, what else could we have used for this client data set? Of course, the BioLife XML file. And we have the data set connected to the data grid via the database adapter components. And so now we are going to introduce filtering. We'll want to offer the user the ability to use an easy dialog for performing filtering on this data set. And so I drop the dataset filter dialog on the form and I connect it to the dataset via the dataset property. So it's hooked up to the client dataset now. And the only other thing, of course, I need to do is offer the ability to invoke the dialog at runtime. And so we do that from a button click. And from that button click, we are going to trigger this dialog, the FNC filter, dataset filter dialog that we will show via the execute method. And that's actually all that there is to do, one single line of code to invoke that dialog. And so here we have it, our it's in this case a VCL application, but note of course that the data grid also works in a FireMonkey cross-platform application, but for this demo we focus on a VCL application. And when I click the filter button, then I'm getting the filter dialog, and from here I can add expressions. It automatically picked up all the fields in my data set. So for example, we can here add a filter where we can pick all the items that start, or all the records that start with an S for category. When I apply that, you can see that it has already automatically filtered this on this condition. You can also see that in this dropdown, it shows automatically all the unique values in this particular field. And let's add maybe another condition. And here we perform, for example, a filter on the length. And notice that the filter operators, of course, apply to the type of data in this particular column. So this is a numeric column. So I can add values like I want to filter on values larger than 50, and maybe yet another condition where I want to see the values that are at the same time lower than 100, for example, this way. And I apply this so you can see that this filtering is immediately applied. And this way we have for all the field types. So if we would have, which we don't have in this case, if we would have a date field, we would see a date picker with the applicable operators for these specific data types. And that's actually all there is to do. Use or drop that filter dialog on the form connected to the data set and invoke the filtering at runtime, and your end users can perform any kind of filtering they would want to in your application. Let's take this to another level, a more custom level, where we will use the filter dialog without a dataset, with data that is just added in the data grid. So what do we have here? We have the data grid. We have, of course, the dialog, the button from where we trigger the filter dialog. So same thing here, we perform the execute. But let's dive a little bit more in how this example is constructed. And everything starts with filling the data with grid. So the what do we do? We first of all set all the columns in the grid that we want to use. And for this particular example, we have added several columns with several data types. So as you can see here, we have a text column. We have a column that is filtered with integer numbers, float, datetime, date, just time, and also a Boolean field. And this type is set in the column header text. And we also set, for example, here the formatting of this particular column to be of the type number, to be of the type float, etc. You can see how this grid is. The columns in this grid are defined this way. And then when we have defined the columns, we create a number of records, rows in that grid filled with random data. So you can see here that we generate some random numeric values, float values, datetime values, etc. Then another thing is when we start the filter dialog, where we fill actually the possible columns on which the filtering in the dialog can be performed. So we do that from the doGetFilterBuilderData columns. So that is the event from the filter dialog that is triggered when it needs to know what kind of fields, columns, in this case for the grid, it needs to offer the user interface the filtering capabilities. And so here you can see we loop through the grid columns, and depending on the type of each column in the grid, we set here the type, where you can see this here, the TMSFNC filter builder data type, in connection with the title of the header of that column. And so that is what we add as columns that will be accessible from our filter dialog. So the header text value, so the user can relate to what column this selection in the filter will apply to, and the actual type, so in this case dates, floats, numbers, text, etc. Let's maybe first run this example so that you already have an idea what is happening. So you can see here the grid filled with random data of different types, and when I click here on filter, what you can see is an already predefined filter. This predefined filter is actually automatically generated from this filter condition that you can see here in the text control. And as you can see here, we have the different columns, the column header text, and this represents, of course, different data types. So you can see when I have selected a date that I have the operators that are applicable for a date, and that I have in this case a date picker. Makes sense when I want to perform filtering on a date. When I want to change something, a filter condition for the text, you can see here that an other range of operators become available here, things like starts with, ends with, etc. And integers, of course, have the operators like larger than, larger equal than, etc. So this is all available for the integers, also floats, etc. So when I click here the apply, what you can see here is that I'm getting green rows and red rows. Green rows are the rows where the filtering is found to be true, and red where it is false. This is because I have selected here in my radio button the highlight option. I could also have chosen the hide option, which means that rows that do not match the filter set will be hidden from the data grid. So let's have a look how we have actually implemented this in connection with the data grid. And for that, we need to have a look at another important variable, which is the filter validate output array. When we look at the definition of that type, you can see here that this is a dynamic array of booleans. So what will happen is that the filter dialog will fill this dynamic array of boolean values with either true or false, indicating whether that row matches our filter condition or not. And from where do we generate that array of boolean values? We actually generate that from, let's have a look here on the validate filter method. So the validate filter method, what it is doing is, first of all, it builds a filter validate input array. So this is the array of values that we feed to the filter, and the filter is performed using the validate filter array, and it returns our dynamic array of boolean values, holding the values true or false, whether a row matches the filter or not. So that is something that the filter builder is actually doing for us after we have filled the input array with the values of the grid. And as you can see, that is happening here. We are looping through all columns, looping through all rows, and we set the values that are found in the data grid cells. And note that if we inspect this type, you can see that this is a dynamic two-dimensional array of the type FNC value. An FNC value is an FNC specific type for a T value, meaning that in that T value you can have strings, dates, numbers, floats, etc. So it can handle different types of data to perform the filtering on. So the AI, or the IA better, input array is filled with these T values retrieved from the grid, and then we execute the validate filter array, and it returns our dynamic array of booleans, holding true false whether the matching filter condition was met or not. And here the set filter method, here in case we have the radio button checked to hide the rows, we use that dynamic array of booleans to either hide or unhide a row. So we use that boolean value. When it is not matching the filter, we of course need to hide that row. When it is matching, we can unhide that row. That is what is happening. That is in case that the radio button is checked for hiding rows. When it is not checked, we actually use this dynamic array of booleans to set a color for the background of rows in our grid. So as you can see here, if this boolean value is true in our dynamic array, we set the background color to green. Otherwise, we set it to red. And that is how you can use our filter dialog also in connection with the data grid that is not bound to a data set, but where you use the results of that filter dialog to filter the data in the grid that is just programmatically filled with it. So again, if I would set it now to hide and invoke the filter dialog, I can, for example, change the value here to another one, let's say 100 in this case, and click apply, you can see that these values are filtered right now. So that is one example of the power of our filter dialog, also in connection with a data grid. Note actually that we created this demo that you can actually download from the description text that comes with this video. We have built this example in connection with a FNC data grid, but this filter dialog, as you have seen in this code, is flexible enough to also bind it to any other type of control. So you see, you simply fill that filter dialog with the input values that it needs to filter on, and in return you get a dynamic array of booleans that you can use to either show or not show, or highlight in specific colors data in whatever control you use in connection with the filter dialog. I hope I have inspired you with this video on the many capabilities, both for the FNC dataset filter dialog, specifically designed to directly work with datasets, but also with the, let's say, generic filter dialog that you can bind yourself to any other types of controls, data, and let your end users use a friendly dialog to perform the filtering this way. Interested in more content like this? Don't forget to subscribe on the subscribe button here under this video, and you will be notified when we have upcoming other interesting videos about the FNC controls. Thank you.